In this lecture, we will discuss about the design of steel structures, mainly the design of tension members. So, before going to that tension member, we should have some basic knowledge about what is a tension member. So, tension members are linear members predominantly subjected to pulling, which tend to stretch or elongate the member. That means the member which is generally subjected to tension or pull. Tension member in a truss is known as a tie, that means a tie member. A rope is a tension member, suspender of cable stayed bridges, and suspension bridges, sag rods or pullings are the other examples of tension members. So wire cables or ropes, that is circular, square, whatever the section may be, and flat bars are the simplest forms of tension members which is used nowadays. So, what are the types of failures in case of tension members? Mainly, there are three kinds of failures in case of tension members. The number one is yielding of the cross section, and the number two is rupture of the net critical section, and the third one is block shear. So, what is yielding of the cross section? Yielding of the cross section occurs when considerable deformation of the member in longitudinal direction takes place before it fractures. So, before fracture, when there is a reduction of area due to heavy stress, so that is mainly caused due to yielding of cross section, which is occurred in case of tension member. And the rupture of the critical section takes place when the net sectional area, that means when the whole diameters are considered, that is the net sectional area of the member reaches the ultimate stress. And the block shear failure, so the block shear failure mainly occurs due to using high grade of steel as well as high grade of bolts. So in case of block shear failure, a segment of the block of material at the end of the member shears out, that means one portion gets shear up from another due to possible use of high grade of steel and high strength bolts, resulting in smaller section. So basically we can say if we are using high strength bolts and the material quality is too high, then we will have smaller section, and that smaller section causes the block shear failure. So we will discuss an analysis problem on this tension member. So go through the problem statement. A tension member consists of a flat 100 mm into 8 mm which is connected to a gusset plate 10 mm thick by two numbers of 16 mm dia bolts. If the steel of grade is Fe410 and bearing bolts of property class 4.6 are used in the workshop, determine the strength of the flat against yielding, rupture and block shear. That means this yielding of cross section, rupture of the critical section and the block shear we have to calculate. Also determine the maximum load the joint can carry safely. So we have to calculate both that strength of the bolt as well as strength of the plate. So the minimum of the strength of the bolt and the strength of the plate will be the strength of the joint. So what are the data given? So already grade of steel has been given and the grade of bolt has been given. So from the grade of steel, for Fe410 grade of steel, Fu, that is the ultimate stress, is 410 MPa, and the Fy yield stress is 250 MPa, and the gamma M0 is 1.1 and the gamma M1 is 1.25. So these gamma values are given in table 5, and these property values Fu, Fy, these are given in table 1. So for 16 mm dia bolts, we take clearance of 2 mm, that is the whole diameter is coming 18 mm, 16 plus 2, that is 18 mm. So for 16 mm dia bolts of property class 4.6, the diameter of the bolt is 16 mm and the diameter of the hole D0 is 18 mm and the gamma MB is coming as 1.25. It has no units. So at first we have to calculate the strength of the plate. So the strength of the plate will be minimum of the threes, that is rupture and then what is coming, yielding and then block shear. So the minimum of these three will be the strength of the plate. So the strength of the plate against yielding of cross section, first we have to calculate Tdg equals to AgFy by gamma m0. So this formula already given in your clause 6.3 of IS code 800-2007, Tdg equals to AgFy by gamma m0. So Ag we have to calculate. So how to calculate Ag? Ag is the gross sectional area, that is D into T. So D is the width, that is 100 millimeter already given in the question. So you can see here a tension member consists of a flat 100 millimeter into 8 millimeter. So 100 millimeter is the width and 8 millimeter is the thickness. So 100 into 8, it is coming Ag, and Fy is given, it is 250. Fy is 250 for Fe410 grade of steel, that is for plate, and gamma m0 is 1.1. So Ag Fy by gamma m0, it is coming around 181.82 kilonewton, and the strength of the plate against rupture of critical section. So look here, this is the cross section of the tension member I have drawn, and you can see here this is 100 millimeter, so 50 50, this is the mid portion, and the end distance is 30 and the pitch is 40, so this portion is also 30. Okay, so this portion is 30 and this is section 11 and this is section 22. So the section 11 will be the critical one, as this is the direction of the loading and this is the outermost side of the direction of the loading. So section 11 will be the critical one. So net effective area, how to calculate the net effective area? So net effective area means we have to deduct the whole diameter. So generally area, we use the formula B into T for area. So deducting the whole diameter, so NDH, where DH is the whole diameter, N is the number of the bolts. So for one bolt there will be only DH. So AN equals to B minus NDH into T. That means B is 100 minus N is 1. N is 1 in this section 11. There is one bolt, and T is 8 millimeter. It has been given in the question. So the net effective area AN is coming around 656 millimeter square, and the TDN. So TDN, how to calculate this TDN? The formula is 0.9 AN FU by gamma M1. So 0.9 is a constant, and FU we have to take 410 for Fe410 grade plates, and 656 already the net effective area we have calculated, divided by gamma M1. So gamma m1 we have taken 1.25 from table 5, and the TDN is coming around 193.65 kilonewton. So now, so for block shear case, so see here, so see this section, this is the critical section 11. So this is the end, and we have to consider this section for the analysis for the block shear case. So we have to take this section. So this is 30 and this is 40. So this sum is around 70 and this is 50. So this is 50. So how to calculate this area? So see, the shaded portion may shear off. So to calculate the block shear failure case, the shaded portion may shear up. So first we have to consider the shaded portion. So you can see, which is visible to in your screen, the shaded portion of dimension 70 into 50. So AVG. So AVG is the area, that is the gross area along the shear plane, that is along the direction of the loading. So how to calculate this? AVG is 1 into 40 plus 30 into 8. So 1 is the deduction, that is we have to deduct here. here, whatever the number of bolt is given, so the number of bolt is coming 1. So shear plane, here it is subjected to single shear case, and here Mn equals to 1 and Ns equals to 1. So FBG, how to calculate? 1 into 40 plus 30. So this is 40 plus 30 into 8. 8 is the thickness. So this is 70 into 8. FBG is coming 560 mm². Now FBN. So in case of FBN, FBN is the net shear area. So B stands for shear and N stands for net. So while calculating net, we have to deduct the number of bolts. So along the shear plane, this is 1 hole diameter and this is the half hole diameter we have to take. So this is 1 and half, that is 1.5. So here you can see 1 plus 0.5, it is coming around 1.5. So as we are calculating in case of FBG, 1 into 40 plus 30, 1 into 40 plus 30, minus, we have to deduct the hole diameter. So here 1, here 0.5. So 1.5 into 18, 18 is the hole diameter, into 8 is the thickness. So FBN is coming 344 mm² and ATG. ATG is the direction perpendicular to the direction of loading. That means this direction is perpendicular to the direction of loading, and while calculating ATG and ATN, we have to calculate in this direction only. So while calculating ATG, the gross area will be calculated. While calculating ATN, this half portion, that is half of the bolt, will be deducted. So how to calculate ATG? So this is 50. So 50 into 8, thickness is 8. So 50 into 8, it is coming 500 mm², that is ATG. So what is ATN? 50 minus 0.5 will be deducted as the hole diameter, half of the hole diameter. 50 minus 0.5 into 18, into 8 is the thickness. So it is coming 328 mm². So now TDB1 and TDB2. So the minimum of the TDB1 and TDB2 will be the block shear strength. So the formula for TDB1 is FBG Fy by root 3 gamma m0 plus 0.9 ATN Fu by gamma m1. So this formula is given in your clause 6.4. So TDB1 is calculated as 170.31 kN. So all the values has been calculated, FBG, FBN, ATG, ATN. Putting all these values, we have to calculate TDB1 as well as TDB2. So the formula for TDB2 is ATGFY divided by gamma m0 plus 0.9 FBN FU by root 3 gamma m1. So putting all the values, TDB2 is calculated as 149.54 kN, and the block shear strength is minimum of TDB1 and TDB2. So the minimum is coming 149.54 as TDB2. So TDB2 is the block shear strength, and the strength of the plate is minimum of bit 1, bit 2 and bit 3. That is strength. So strength of the plate against yielding of gross cross section, strength of the plate against rupture of critical section, and strength of the plate against block shear. So the minimum of these three will be the strength of the plate. So after calculating the strength of the plate, we have to calculate the strength of the bolt. So how to calculate the strength of the bolt? So look at here. If one plate is overlapped over another, so here the shear plane is 1. So as the shear plane is 1, so Nn will be 1, Ns will be 0. So it is in case of single shear. So here Nn will be 1, Ns will be 0, and we have to calculate the area of the bolt at shank level. So the bolt diameter is 16. So ANB, so how to calculate ANB? That ANB equals to pi by 4 multiplied by 16 square. So ANB equals to pi by 4 into 16 square into 0.78. So 0.78 is used for calculating net area, and the shank area ASB equals to pi by 4 into 16 square. So first we have to calculate pi by 4 16 square. It is coming 201 millimeter square, and we have to multiply 0.78 for calculating the net area, and the ANB is coming 157 millimeter square. So now we have to calculate VDSB as well as VDNB. So VDSB, the formula is FUB by root 3 gamma MB into MN ANB plus NS ASB. So as NS is 0, so NS ASB part will be totally 0. So FUB by root 3 gamma MB into MN ANB will be the VDSB, and putting all the values, the VDSB is coming around 29.01 kilonewton for 1 bolt. So the strength of the bolt in bearing against the thinner plate, that is we have to calculate the VDPB. So the formula for VDPB is 2.5 kbdtfu divided by gamma mb. So what is the kb? The kb is the minimum of this 4. So the minimum of this 4, we have to calculate E by 3D0, where E is the end distance already given in the question. The end distance is 30 millimeter. So D0 is the hole diameter. 30 divided by 3 multiplied by 18. So it is coming 0.355. And the bit 2 is P by 3D0 minus 0.25. So it is 40. Pitch is 40 by 3 into 18 minus 0.25. It is coming 0.491, and the third one is FUB by FU, that is 400 by 410, and it is coming 0.976, and the fourth one is 1. So the minimum of this 4 is 0.491, that is P by 3D0 minus 0.25. So KB is coming 0.491. So putting this value of KB, VDPB is coming 2.5 kbdtfu divided by gamma mb. So putting all these values and gamma mb as 1.25, VDPB is coming 51.54 kilonewton, and the bolt value is minimum of the VDSB and VDPB, and VDSB we have already calculated 29.01 kilonewton, and VDPB is calculated 51.54 kilonewton. So the bolt strength is 29.01 kilonewton, as it is the minimum. So this is the bolt value for 1 bolt, and you can see in this section there are 2 bolts. So for 2 bolts, the joint strength is 2 into strength of 1 bolt. So strength of 1 bolt is 29.01, and strength of the 2 bolt is multiplied by 2, it is coming 58.02 kilonewton. So the maximum load the joint can carry safely, it has been asked in the question. So the maximum load the joint can carry safely is the minimum of the bolt strength and the plate strength. So the bolt strength is 58.02 kilonewton, and the plate strength is 149.54 kilonewton. So the strength of the joint is minimum of the strength of the bolt as well as plate. So it is coming 58.02 kilonewton. So there is a mistake in 58.03 kilonewton, and the answer is 58.02 kilonewton. Thank you for your patience hearing.